peace and welcome back to my channel, Sarasia Andrea. So you guys don't kill me, but I know it kind of took a little bit a while for this video to go up. That is because I had the last minute go to Atlanta, super last minute for like 4 days, but I'm back in. I was supposed to post this video when I was out there on Thursday, but silly me, I forgot one of my cores that I needed. So I was not able to edit it while I was out there, and I couldn't even get any footage to my editor because hello, I didn't have the cord. So today is Sunday. I'm just gonna post a video today. I barely post on Sundays, but it is what it is, because I need to really get this video out because I have so much to post next week. This video is sponsored by West Kiss Hair. You guys have seen them on YouTube all over. They are an affordable AliExpress brand, and I'm going to be reviewing their 613 hair. I've never reviewed hair for them before, but I would definitely say to you guys, they are definitely in my top three favorite 613 blonde hair edition ever from AliExpress. It does not shed. It is definitely one of the most silkiest textures that I've used thus far, and it's definitely thick for you know, the texture that I like. I did go ahead and use straight from them, and I did use a body wave frontal. I did get both in 16 inch, but off camera when I was washing out the hair, I did just go ahead and just cut the ends off because I did not need it, and I just felt like it would be easier for me to wash and condition and all that jazz. But yeah, so I'm actually just right here just coloring the hair. You guys know I never ever ever know the hair theme that I want to do when it comes to coloring wigs. I just pretty much plop a blonde wig in front of me, grab some colors, and just go with my hands. This one is pretty much kind of similar to the same color theme that I did in my last coloring video. As far as putting colors randomly, I don't know what it is with me doing this technique lately, but I definitely just feel like that has just been my trend. I've just pretty much just been getting colors that you wouldn't normally see go together and just putting them randomly in different spots on the wig. This one, I felt it was a little bit more on the yellow theme side, and the back of the wig was just like a popcorn effect of pinks and orange and yellow and purple, and you know, different type of variation of purple colors and different variations of pink colors. I also definitely went in and put some lavender, and this one was really just about getting colors that are very bold but very light at the same time, and just hoping for the best and just putting them in random spots and hoping it came out bomb, which it did, and I'm just so happy. But you guys love this color on Instagram. You went crazy. You felt like it was just so unique and just so different and just so bomb. So I'm happy to finally be giving you guys content that you're like, yes, this is what we've been waiting for. This is why we love you. You are back at it. And that's just kind of what I've been reaching for, because I felt like I lost it for a little bit, but I feel like I'm getting it back. So that's cool. So I'm just going to be going ahead and just putting the colors randomly all over the place. And you guys already know, I just went ahead and just put all the colors that I use in the proportions that I put down below in the description box. If you guys have any questions about anything, where the hair is from, the link to it, the colors that I use, the links to those, and all that jazz, definitely go ahead down in the description box and click on all the links. Some of the codes are affiliated, so if you guys don't really like that, you know, I tell you guys all the time, just don't click it. Just go to a different browser and do it that way. But if you guys don't really care, then, you know, definitely go ahead and click on the link. So I'm just going to finish up putting all the color on the wig. Then I'm just going to go ahead and wash it out on camera and show you guys that portion of the video. So in this part, I'm just going ahead and rinsing out the hair. It did not give me any troubles. I did not really have any, not fallout. What do I say? I didn't have any other color really rinse out. I did let the dye sit on for overnight. And usually when I do that, the dyes literally cling onto the hair like no other. And I never have any problems with it rinsing out or coming out or anything like that. So if you guys always have that problem with your colors always rinsing out really badly, try, if you have time, try leaving the colors on overnight, and I promise you it will literally cling onto the hair and you will not have the problem with it bleeding or anything. So that is definitely a tea tip for that. I'm also giving you guys all the info as far as tinting the knots on my 613 wigs and blending in the roots to make it look a little bit more natural as far as women of color or dark skinned girls. I do consider myself a brownie, so you know, for people that don't really consider me dark skin, I am definitely more melanin. I'm a brown skin girl. So I do show you guys the colors that I like to use from Wella Color Charm. It is their color Tango line, and I do use the color 7NN and 7B. I mix them together 50-50, and I do add it with some 20 developer from color Wella Color Charm as well, and I mix those together and start to apply it. Now I do only leave the process in for about 5 minutes. You don't want to leave it in too long because you don't want it to process too dark and have your roots be darker than your actual skin. The whole purpose is basically just to have everything blend in together, make it look a lot more natural, and you don't want to be too crispy, you know. So I'm just going ahead with my feather applicator. I will leave that down below as well, because that is definitely another huge secret that I use. You don't want to use applicator that's too thick and heavy. You want to use something that's super lightweight because you want to get the effortless look of blending in your roots and not have anything too harsh. I just went ahead and processed it for 5 minutes, but I didn't say that already. And then I just went ahead and put in my After Color Sealer from Ion. I didn't know what I want to say. From Ion. And then I let that sit for about 20 minutes and then rinse it out. Let it dry. And now this is like the third day. I be telling y'all that these videos be like 3 days worth of filming. Y'all don't be believing me, but I be telling y'all. But this is like the third day. I did let the hair dry overnight again. And then 90% dry, I like to come back on camera, blow dry it, so you guys can see all different dimensions, all the different highlights, low lights of every single color. And it just looked freaking amazing. So bomb. I will tell you guys the tea. I definitely thought this wig was gonna be super clownish when I was doing it. I got so nervous and so scared. I will tell you guys a little secret. I think the best way to really pull off super crazy colored hair is by doing it into bobs. I think it's like the best, easiest way to do it. Not even if you're gonna do a bob, at least do it to like about 16 inches. I wouldn't really go any darker than that. If you guys are super scared to really pull off crazy colored combos like this, I would definitely say start by doing it short and then working your way down when you start to get a little bit more bold and a little bit more creative and a little bit more you know, fierce as far as rocking colored hair. So that is a little tip for you guys. So I'm just going ahead and blow dry it. I do straighten it off camera, and I do show you guys on camera when I went ahead and layered it with some scissors, and I do cut a little bit of the bang on camera as well. Thank you. Now, I did go ahead and do this makeup look on camera in my last video. I think it's definitely titled like Natural Everyday Bee or something along those lines. So if you guys are curious about this makeup look, definitely go and check that out. My enticing lashes will be out this week. All of my new lashes will be up this week. So you guys don't worry. We are finally getting everything together. Y'all be trying to be patient with me, y'all. Like, I'm trying to get my life together. Like, gosh, okay? But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm so happy to finally get this video out for you guys. I hope you guys enjoy it. It's super different. I have not seen anything like it, and I was super scared, but I'm happy it all panned and worked out. So I definitely love to see you guys in my next video. It is going to be a revamping of an old wig that I have from a different company, because I want to show you guys my new elastic band method that I like to do, as well as new plucking, new bleaching techniques, and everything new that I do to get my wig so slayed. So deuces, hope to see you guys. Bye.